back in Power BI, and in today's video, we are going to show you a data visualization technique that you can use to make a dynamic card title change with a measure. And we're going to use this using the conditional formatting feature for card titles. So a lot of times when you use a card visual, you have a couple of options. You can turn off the card title, or you can put in your own text. But this way, we can create a visual, and we're going to show you how to use it for either sales or units, and it's going to be dynamically driven by using conditional formatting. Let's go to Power BI. In Power BI, we continue to learn Power BI, and in today's video, we are going to show you dynamic card with conditional formatting. And what this allows you to do is change your card title by using conditional formatting. What you see here is the finished product. We have a couple of examples to show you. We have a regular dynamic card. And when you put the measure in this card, you see 83,000 total units because the name of the measure is total units. Now, with a dynamic card in the title, we can use conditional formatting so that when we change the slicer, you notice the total units June 2020 year to date from the slicer is pulled into the card title. And if you change this back to 2018, the dynamic card title changes to 2018. This is something you may want to use when you want to have the user know exactly what they're looking at for numbers. Now, remember, you can follow along by downloading the AW Dynamic Card file in the description below. It is the AdventureWorks file. It is completely set up with the data model, and we will show you how to do the dynamic card in your titles with conditional formatting so that when you change the physical year, you can change it anywhere from the slicer, and this will change in your dynamic card. Let's show you how to do this in Power BI. Let's create a dynamic card title with conditional formatting. You can download the AdventureWorks file below, or you can use this on one of your own Power BI files. If you're downloading the AdventureWorks file, look in the description, download the file, and then save it as AW Dynamic Card, and then your initials. So what I'm going to do first off is create a new page. Now what we want to do is create the initial units measure, units sold measure. We're going to create some extra room by collapsing the build portion of the Power BI file. Then we are going to select the sales table. We are going to create one measure. It's going to be called units sold. And the DAX formula for this is using the sum function. Now the sum function, when you use your IntelliSense, requires a column name. And in this example, the AdventureWorks file, we have a bunch of columns, and the one we want to use is the order quantity. So when we use the order quantity and we sum that up and we close that out with the right parentheses, that will give us our units sold measure. That is the first step in creating a dynamic card with conditional formatting in the title. To show you how this works, next, we're going to bring in from the file, we're going to bring in the slicer for the year. We're going to put this at the top. We're going to go to the date and bring in the fiscal year. Next, we're going to make this a little bit bigger so that you can see on the different settings. When you select the title and the slicer header, we're going to make this a 16 point. And then for the values, we're going to make this 16 point. So that way you can clearly see all of the different values. Next, when you choose the card title, select a blank area in the design area, select on the card title. Now, when we bring in from the data section, we can bring in units sold. So that gives us our 275,000 units sold. Now, the slicer does work, but the user may not be able to, depending on the report style you have, you can look and see what the user is selecting. Now, this user could be using 2019. They may want to look at fiscal year 2020, but in the actual card title, it doesn't change dynamics. So they'd have to look up here to see the context of that 167,000 units sold. They would want to know, well, what year is that? Well, right now they'd have to look up here to see that. But if we choose to create a dynamic title, they can see that right in the card measure. And we're going to show you how to do that next by creating a second measure. Then we're going to use conditional formatting to use that measure. Let's create the conditional title formatting. We're going to create a second measure, and we're going to name this from the sales table. We're going to create a new measure. We're going to call this last period. And what this allows us to do is show the last period in the slicer. Now, the formula for this is we're going to break it down. The first thing we're going to do, if you're new to Power BI and DAX, we're going to combine a couple of measures. The first one is called the max. So if you take the max, what max does, it takes the latest, if you read the IntelliSense, it returns the largest numeric value or largest string in a column. But that is also the final date from the date column. So we're going to use the date table. And if we select date and we close this out, now we have the last period. So if we bring this into a card, we create another card, we bring this last period into that card, it's going to show for FY 2020, 6/30/2020, because the July 1st starts the new fiscal year in this AdventureWorks. If we go to 2019, it changes to 6/30/2019. If we go to 2018, it now changes to 6/30/2018. So we're halfway through the formula. Now we only want the dynamic text, and then we want to format this to month and year. So we're going to update this measure. The first thing we're going to do is add, remember, you can add text inside a measure, and we're going to call this total units space, then end of quotes. Now we're going to use an ampersand, and we're going to use a function called format. And when we use format, we're still going to have it wrapped inside the max formula. But now when we go to the end of the date, we're going to close this out, and then you're going to use a comma. And if you look at your IntelliSense, you have the format. Now the format we want is going to be inside quotation marks, just like if you've ever used Excel and you've used the format function. If we want three letter abbreviation for month, we're going to choose month, 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 three M's. Then we're going to bring in all four numbers from the year. So Y is going to give us the year. If we went with two Y's, that would bring us in the last two portions of the year. Next, we need to close that out for the formatting for the years. we do need to close out the parentheses. Then we add the concatenation of the quotes and then YTD for year to date. And all we need to do is just close that out with the quotes. So the formatting now is going to be last period, total units, and format the maximum of the date that is currently selected in the slicer. So when you hit enter, we've now updated that format. And if you notice, the formatting changes. Now we have total units. And when we select the slicer, it changes from 2018 to 2019. Then it changes to 2020. So now we've created the initial unit sold formula for the measure. Now we've created this helper measure called last period. The final thing we need to do is create the card and then apply the conditional formatting. We know the formatting on the measure is working correctly. We have total units. Then when we select the slicer, it changes. Now all we need to do is click on a blank area of the visual gallery, select a card. We bring the card in, and now from our measures, we're going to bring in units sold. So now it's just a regular measure for the card. Next, we want to choose the formatting options for that card. We want to turn off the category label. That will delete the units sold. Next, for the title, it is currently defaulted to off. We want to turn on the title, select the dropdown, and from the text for the title, we want to select this conditional formatting option. When we select the conditional formatting option, that is going to bring up our list of all the different measures that we have available. And from the sales table, we are going to select the last period measure. Now we just select OK, and then we have our title measure in there, total units, June 2020. We're going to make this a little bit bigger. We're going to choose heading 4. We're going to make this up to a 16 point, and we're going to make this bold. So now when we select 2019, we select 2018. Now that we know that it's working, we can delete the practice text box up here. And when we select 2019, 2020, the user will know right away what finance period we're looking at. And what's nice about this is we can create a new page, go back to the existing page, we can copy this, and then we can paste this into the new page. And from this page, if you select the finance year, it changes on that additional page. So now we can create a dashboard, and we don't need to bring in the slicer on this page. By selecting 2020, it changes on this page. And if we select the slicer on this page, we don't have to have a slicer in there. It automatically changes. So that is what is building a conditional title from the conditional formatting option. Dynamic card visuals are one of the most popular visuals used in Power BI, and the ability to make them dynamic is even better when you're learning Power BI and you're starting to create your dashboards. Remember, you can follow along by downloading the file below the AdventureWorks file in the description. If you have your own Power BI files, you can create the measure for the max of from your date calendar. Next, you just create the formatting. And remember, we use total units in this example, but this could be total sales. This could be total, whatever totals you want to use, or even the formatting. If you didn't like the total units and you just want to have total, you can change that from the parameters inside that last period visual, and then you just update to whatever conditional formatting you want inside the conditional formatting options in that visuals. So that is how to create a dynamic card title using conditional formatting. Remember to watch our most recent visuals. You can watch more additional videos on conditional formatting and creating DAX visualizations in Power BI. Remember to like, share, and subscribe as we continue to learn Power BI.